What's up, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to my simple and easy to follow Easter egg guide for the Liberty Fall map on Call of Duty Black Ops 6 Zombie. Along with doing the Easter egg, I am also going to show you some tips and strategies that you can employ to make things a bit easier for you. Like the first one is at the start of every round, come right here and melee this vending machine. And this vending machine has a chance to drop some ammo, some salvage, even perks, and even a ray gun, but it's all RNG based. Then come up here to this hotel room and open this room up. A lot of zombies will pour out. This is actually the room where we are going to be assembling the jet gun. So it's good to just get these zombies out and kill them right away, because you know in the later rounds they can be a pain, and right now they are going to give you some precious essence or cash, whatever you want to call it, and that is going to come really handy for us. These guys are a little bit aggressive, so watch out for that. And if you are wondering why how I am killing them with just one hit from my knife, that is because I have the Casecracker knife equipped, and we have already unlocked that in the campaign. If you guys want, there will be a link for that in the description of this video, which you can go check out if you don't have it. After that, I just suggest staying in the spawn area till like wave 4. There you see, at the start of wave 3, this vending machine dropped me a rare Ethereum crystal, which upgraded my weapon to pack a punch level 1, which is awesome. I'm trying to keep this guide free of using gobble gums or any such things which you may or may not have, or not dependent on RNG. So you know that Ethereum crystal dropped for me, it may or may not drop for you. So I will tell you strategies for other things as well to maybe hopefully help you out in case you are struggling with this map. So if that helps you, please do remember to give this video a like and also consider subscribing to my channel. So once we are done with this, we are going to start assembling the jet gun. For this, from the spawn, follow this route, come all the way over here and pick up this water valve right here. Now we are going to run all the way back to spawn, but before that there is a bonus point that we can pick up by coming over here behind the comic book shop and shooting that AC. There is a bonus point you can see above the vent. If you shoot right in the corner, you can pick it up. Now we are going to go to the bowling lane and do the water pressure gauge step for the Easter egg. I am doing this right away because this is the most annoying step, so it's better to get it off in the first wave. So melee this panel, install the water valve, and then you have to hold square on it to get the water pressure built up. You can do it at any point in the wave, it does not really matter, because apart from the normal zombies from the waves that are spawning, there will be a bunch of zombies that will come out just to protect this water gauge. So you have to watch out for them and you know just take them down running around and killing them. So once you have dealt with the zombies and you have filled up the water pressure gauge of this meter or this lever, whatever it is, the zombies will burn up and you can finally pick up the water pressure gauge right here. With our first piece of the jet gun out of the way, we can finally make our way to the church and come here and interact with this panel. This will trigger a scene where the guy up there is going to talk. He's going to talk and talk and talk. And you have to wait till he's done, he's finished talking. And once he's done, I don't know if he does it automatically, but I would advise interacting with the panel again. So, because basically the dialogue you're looking for is that I have patched into your signal. When he says that, that is when we are going to head over to the graveyard and wait for the groundskeeper zombies. There, he's given us the dialogue that we needed. So now we are going to come over here and wait for the groundskeeper zombie to spawn. You're going to stay in this area for a couple of rounds, and the groundskeeper zombie is actually pretty elusive. This guy, that is actually an old guy in dungarees with beard and a hat, and he is very elusive because he always spawns right at the end of the round, and if you kill all the other zombies, he can run away and even disappear or vanish, like he just glitches out or teleports away. So make sure to kill him when he spawns, otherwise you are just going to keep going through rounds and not getting him, because once he vanishes, I think he does not spawn for, like, he spawns in alternative rounds, he does not spawn till the next round. I'm going to show you what he looks like so you know exactly what you're looking for. Basically, just remember that the only guy that is going to be running away from you and not towards you when you're killing zombies That's the groundkeeper zombie, and you have to kill that guy. So there you see on the right the one zombie that is running away. That's our groundkeeper zombie that we're looking for. Here's another angle of this guy. He's running away there. When you aim at him, as I said, it shows groundkeeper. So make sure to kill him as soon as you see him. Then once he's dead, you can pick up the toolshed key from him and come all the way over here to the toolshed and pick up the second part for the jet gun, which is the handbrake. For the next part, we need to enter this door, and it can only be opened with a Mangler cannon. So there are a few tricks you can try. You can try standing between a Mangler and the door when he aims at you, or you can try breaking his arm. But these things, while economical, are tricky. The safest way is to just use your salvage points and craft a Mangler cannon, and then once you have it, go up to the door and blow it up. Once you get inside, there will be some piles of debris which you have to press square on, and there you see, first try, I got the electrical wires. There are 4 or 5 piles of debris overall, and some of them can have enemies, most of them have salvage, and one of them will include the electrical wires. Now that we have all the 3 parts, come over here to the spawn and enter this room in the hotel which we opened during the first wave. And inside there will be a half assembled jet gun which you can press square on it to assemble it. And there you go people, you have the jet gun now, and now we can start moving up with the Easter egg. Now the next step for us is to actually craft the LTG. And for that we are going to rush back to the comic book store and get the first part. So come over to the comic book store, look to the hole in the middle and use your jet gun to grab the first part. Then we are going to run away, run ahead and get to the roof on the left over here, and then jump on the truck park below. In here, just look at the window and use your jet gun to grab the second part. Now that's done, we can rush to the church. And once inside the church, we have to look up on the right to grab the third part. And now we can start crafting the LTG. So come back to the roof where we jumped to the truck from and unlock the zipline to the roof of the bank. And then zipline to the bank, and on the left corner is where you can craft the LTG. Once the LTG is crafted, make sure you press square to pick it up. Then we come back to the church and interact with this canister to pick it up. You might have to listen to some dialogue before you can do that. Also, once you pick up the canister, you can no longer run or dash or jump even. So just make sure you're doing it when you are at the end of the round to stay safe. So bring the canister all the way over to the spawn. You can also drop it at this ether trap if you want, but we are going to drop it at the ether trap at spawn, because I think that makes the second trek with the canister that more economical, I would say, because you get unlock the second canister here. So drop this canister down, and once that's down, you come over here and put the LTG on this lightning event that is going on. Now zombies are going to rush towards this LTG, and the LTG is going to charge up, and we have to protect it for 1 minute. If the zombies get close to it, they will get sucked into the LTG and damage it. So just keep your wits about and protect the LTG for a minute, and then we can move on with the next step. Now once you're done protecting the LTG for a minute, either a Mangler or an Abomination is going to spawn. For me, it was a Mangler. So just bring him back down close to the canister, activate this trap, and then have the Mangler die when he's trapped in that. So there you see his essence is going to get trapped into the canister. You can damage the Mangler beforehand, but don't kill him. So now once that you have trapped the Mangler's essence into the canister, you are going to rush back to the church and deposit this canister. Again, with the canister picked up, you cannot dash or dive or run. And this time, this event is actually timed. So just make sure you get the canister to the church in the machine in the church in time. You have plenty of time, so nothing to worry about. Just watch out for zombies that they do not down you, or otherwise you'll have to do the whole step all over again. Once you deposit the canister into the device, a compartment is going to open up on the left, which is gonna give you a signal meter that will replace your tactical weapon, your L1 gun. I mean L1 equipment. So with this, we have to now align the signal of 3 devices. The first device is right over here. You come over here and you press L1 on your meter to check what color if it is showing. If it is showing green, you have to align it to red. If it is showing yellow, you need to align it to yellow. and if it is showing red, you have to align the machine to green. So once again we are going to the second one. Again I think my meter is going to be yellow, and if you do it correctly you will hear like a double ping sound come out of the machine. Here I am going to align it and you can hear it out. Again for the third machine we are going to once again head to the roof. We are going to zip line there and come over and blow up this barrier, and this will give us access to the third machine. Again my signal is green, so I am going to align it to red, and if done correctly all three machines are going to move and the signal is going to align and unlock the barrier or the beaker that was sitting at the spawn right from the start of the game, and that is gonna have our second canister. So pick up this canister and walk all the way to the second trap, second aether trap, and also make sure to pick up the LTG on the way. I skipped it and had to backtrack it, so make sure you do pick it up for the next step. So come over here and then we are going to place this canister on next to this trap right here. Now we are going to go and start the next LTG trap sequence, where we again have to protect the LTG for one another minute. Once you are done defending the trap, an abomination is going to step out of it this time. So drag this, I mean lure this abomination all the way to the trap, activate the trap, and just like last time, have it killed when it is next to the canister and into the effects of the trap. So there you see, his essence is also going to get trapped, and now we are going to rush this beaker back to the church. Once you deposit this beaker, be sure not to press square right away because that will lock you into the boss fight. And we need some preparations done before that. Make sure you have your armor to at least level 2. If you can get it to level 3, it's good. Make sure you have increased your weapon rarity to at least epic, and that it is pack-a-punch level 2 at least, your main weapon. If you don't have a ray gun like me, then your other weapon, it is good to have mutant injections if you can, and symbol monkeys as well. So if you're solo in this round, once we come here, press square again, and now we are going to be going through three waves of zombies. In the first two waves, a lot of zombies and some manglers are going to spawn. And in the final wave, we are going to have to deal with an abomination additionally, and there will still be a lot of manglers running around, as well as a lot of normal armored and heavy zombies. So, and this is actually a cramped space, so it is easy to get trapped in here. There will be two, like after each wave, once a max armor and a max ammo will spawn, so there will be some few seconds of respite in between, and also there is an ammo crate here from which you can pick up ammo. So make sure to just keep running around, keep moving and keep killing zombies as much as you can. If you have symbol monkeys, use them. If you have mutant injections, save them for the abomination, but as soon as the abomination spawns, use your mutant injections and you're good. It's not very tough as far as Easter eggs go. Also, one neat trick I found out, that if you have napalm burst on your weapon, there are candles all around the church. If you hit those candles with the napalm burst weapon, then actually fire is going to rain down from the sky. That fire will damage the zombies as well as you. So it can work in your favor, it cannot work in your favor, but that is just something you should know. So simple strategy, just keep killing zombies, and by the end of it, once you're done, you will have completed the Easter egg. You will know you have completed the Easter egg because the game is going to down you automatically. Once that happens, it means the Easter egg is complete. Also forgot to mention, if you're playing solo, make sure you have quick revives at this point, because quick revive is going to be very very crucial for your survival. It is very easy to get downed here. There you see I am throwing my symbol monkeys and stuff, and just throw everything at them. Once the abomination spawns, just throw everything at it and hopefully you can make it. So that's it folks, that is my no-nonsense step-by-step Easter egg guide for the Liberty Falls map of Call of Duty Black Ops 6 Zombies. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I really hope I was able to help you people out. If you did like it, if I did help you out, please give me a like and subscribe to my channel. And also let me know your feedback in the comment section. And apart from that, as always, wherever you are, whatever you are doing, please stay safe, stay healthy, and stay busy playing some good games. This is your friend Galactus, and I'm going to leave you with the ending of the Easter egg right now. After the Easter egg is done, you actually have a choice to continue playing or you can just exit.
Interruptions for this next part. Thank you, my friends, for volunteering to take my place here. Or, in your parlance, thank you for being voluntold. Now, if you will excuse me, I have a few scores to settle. Bye-bye, Dark Aether.